Hello and welcome to this talk about Accelerofor. Before we begin, let me introduce myself. I'm Yvan Lusseau. I'm working at OBEO since 2008. Among other things, I'm working on Accelero and AQL. I also work on M2Doc, a Word document generator. The main idea of text generation is to leverage existing models for our specification to produce code or documentation. It can be useful when the targeted technology is different from the Java environment. For instance, C language or configuration files. It can also be useful to document existing models using Markdown or HTML. Another use case can be a one-shot generation to scaffold future developments. To generate text with Accelero, you will need a model that will be used as a data source and a module file that contains the structure of the targeted text. Accelero will then apply templates from provided module to each machine element of the model. The result is an arborescence of text files. Our solution for text generation is Accelero. Accelero is the first open source product developed at OBEO. It has been around since 2007 and is still maintained to this day. But what is a module? A module is similar to a class in oriented object programming. It can extends other modules, it can import service classes or other modules, and it contains templates and queries. One of its templates can be used as an entry point for generation using the @main command. Templates and queries are similar to methods in object-oriented programming. The main difference between templates and queries is that templates always return text and queries can return any type of object. They are both used to structure the Accelero code. A template can contain a list of statements. The first statement you probably want to use is the file statement. It allows to create files to a given location. The file can be created in two ways: overwrite mode, that will create the file if it doesn't exist, or overwrite it and replace its content if it exists, or create mode, which will only generate the content of the file if it doesn't exist. You can also specify the encoding of the output file. The content will be generated using the body of the file statement. The first statement allows to loop over elements of a collection. Here, we are looping over a list of classifiers and write a dash and the classifier name on each line. To choose between many blocks to generate, you can use the if statement. Here, we are generating no classifier, one classifier, or 8 classifiers, for instance, depending on the number of classifiers present in the classifier's reference. In Accelero, all variables are immutable, but you can define new variables using the let statement. The created variable will be accessible in the body of the let. It can be useful to improve legibility or performance since the value will be computed only once. We decided to write Accelero4 mainly because of performance issues in the development environment for large projects. In some cases, the development environment was not responding. The limit with Accelero3 was around 100 modules for 25,000 lines of code. We now can go over 300 modules and 300,000 lines of code. But we also decided to get rid of the EMTL file, which are compiled version of EMTL file. they tend to become very large and are time consuming to write and read. And last but not least, we integrated AQL, which stands for Accelero Query Language, in Accelero. It's already integrated in Sirius and M2Doc. AQL brings some interesting features. The first one is union types. It allows a variable to have one or many types. In the example, you can see a list of e-packages and e-classifiers. Since both have a feature name, you can write list.name without issue. But if you try to call e-classifiers, which exist only for e-packages, you will get a warning telling you that you might end up with an empty collection. If you try to access the feature e-classifiers on an element of the list, you will have a warning since it may raise an error at runtime. Union types are useful when you have to deal with many metamodels or metamodels that serve other purposes than text generation. The second interesting feature is type inference. In this example, we check if the variable is an e-package. And in the Zen block, you can see that we don't need any cast to access the e-classifier feature. In the else-if, we check if the variable is an e-operation, but in this case, it can't be. So we have an information message telling you that the condition is always false. And finally, the else block, we don't need a cast neither, because at this point, the variable can only be an e-classifier. This feature is useful for legibility and can prevent mistakes. When you need to implement complex behavior, you can use services. Services are Java methods. To use them in Accelero 4, you need to import the service class. And then you can call the service directly, like the getMessage service in this example. At the bottom, you have the implementation of the service that returns a string, but it could return any type of object. In Accelero 4, white space management has also been changed. We didn't want to add a specific language construct for static text, but at the same time, we want to be able to differentiate the template indentation from the generated text indentation. So we introduced a mandatory indentation of two characters in blocks. You can see them in yellow here. They are not generated in the output. To keep generated indentation, the last generated line will be used to indent the generated output. Here it's represented in red. But that's only apply to indented blocks. Inlined blocks will be generated as is. This way you can still fine tune your output text. I will now demonstrate the development environment and the debugger for Accelero 4. So here you can see the editor for EMTL file. As you can see, there is a syntactic highlighting. You can also navigate from a reference to a variable to its declaration, as shown here. You can also navigate from module import to the module itself. Another way to navigate is to use the outline. Here, you can navigate on templates or the attribute of the template. We also provide completion by using control space. And you can see that the documentation for services is also visible when you use the completion. And if you misspell a service name, you will have an error report that will tell you that the service can't be found. I will now start a debug session. So as you can see here, we have a breakpoint on this line. And I will show you the launch config. So the first element of the launch config is the template itself. And the second element is the model we are using for the generation. And at the bottom, you can see the destination folder we choose. When we hit the breakpoint, we are asked if we want to switch to the debug perspective. So I switch to this perspective. At the right side, you see the list of variables that are accessible at this point. On the left side, we have the stack. So I will step into the template, and as you can see, we have now a new element in the stack, and I can go to each stack frame. I can step return. I can also step over. And now I will run the generation to completion in order to show you the result. And in the output folder, we can see generated files. So here we are on the files for the food class. And we have the list of e-attributes, references, and e-operation. The editor you saw in the demonstration has been built on top of the language server protocol. The LSP goal is to decorrelate the language from the development environment. The language is implemented in a server that can be used in any IDEs that is compatible with LSP. In a similar way, we use debug adapter protocol to implement the debugger. Both implementation of the LSP and DAP can be found in LSP4G, both client and server side. And the client side for Eclipse can be found in Eclipse 5 project. LSP greatly improves the development of the editor and the debugger. You need to implement some extension points client-side and few interfaces server-side, but it comes at a cost. You are limited to the protocol itself. For instance, we can't provide a code template in the editor, and we had to map Accelo concepts with existing concepts in the protocol. Also, the syntax highlighting is made client-side using TextMate, and it requires a lot of regular expression and was a bit of a pain to write. It's also frustrating because everything is available server-side for syntax coloration. So, will we see Accelo 4 in other IDEs, unfortunately not at the moment because we have a dependency to the GDT. But we totally encourage language developers to use LSP. For Accelo 3 users, we also implemented a migration tool. It requires the Accelo 3 project to be built with Accelo 3, so EMTL files are accessible. The migration supports service calls and most of OCL services, but protected areas are not supported yet by Accel04, and some commands might be lost in the process of migration. You can find Accel04 on the Eclipse project page, eclipse.org/accelio. Accel04 is out for the community to test. It's the first version including AQL. We want to improve the language with incremental generation. We also want to improve tooling in the future. We want to add tooling like a profiler and code coverage tool. And of course, we plan to integrate with OBO Cloud Platform and Sirius Web. The takeaway of this talk is that you can use Accelio to generate any kind of text from EMF compliant models. It's a modern language with union types and type inference. It's easy to use and have a nice error reporting. There is a migration tools for Accelio 3 projects. Thank you for your attention. Do you have any questions?
So I have some question here. So the first one is what should I do if I already have some Accelio 3 projects and I want to move to Accelio 4? So the first things you need to do is to compile your project with Accelio 3 and then use the migration tool to migrate to Accelio 4. And then you will still have some changes to do in order to make your generator works, but it will help to use the migration tool. Another question is what is the advantages of Accelio 4 compared to Xtend's query language? So in Accelio 4, you have type inference and also union type. I'm not sure if it's available in Xtend, but it's really useful to ease the writing of templates. There is a question about Eclipse J. So for the moment, the development environment is only available inside Eclipse. We did not make any test with Eclipse J. Another question is, can Accelio debugger step into Java services? So for the moment, it's not supported, but it has not been supported for a long time also on Accelio 3. So we'll try to improve that point because it's it can be really useful to be able to debug Java services at the same time as you debug your generators. One question about the packaging with Maven. So now we don't have a compilation phase, so we don't produce any artifacts specific to Accelio. So you can use a standard Java packager to package your generator. And the last question is it possible to launch the generation from Java? So yes, Accelio 4 engine is totally standalone. So you can use it or integrate it in your application like any other Java code. So I think that's all for the question for the moment. So I will wait. Okay. So OBO has a virtual booth, so do not hesitate to join us to discuss about Accelo 4. There is one other question. So the question is it possible to run Accelo transformation without Java generated code? So at the moment, I'm not sure. I think that's referred to the generated class that help to launch the module. So at the moment, you don't need specific code. You can run it using the launch configuration. And there is a few line of code to use to integrate the launch of a module. This is documented in the documentation available when you install the Accelo 4 product. There is another question: is how does it scale with large models and generators? So for the moment, we mainly focus on the development environment. Regarding performances, and it scale pretty well. For the generation, we are confident since we rely on AQL, which has been used in other OBO products and run pretty fast. So we don't have figures for the generation times, but I think it's it should be effective. Okay, thank you, and I hope to see you in the virtual booth of OBO.